Welcome to the 2022 People's Choice Awards at Pemberton Township High School. The People's Choice Award program celebrates Pemberton students who have demonstrated one or more of our core values here at Pemberton Township. Empathy, perseverance, integrity, and gratitude are threaded through all that we do here on a daily basis and our overall mission.
So just a brief history. The People's Choice Award has been around for over 20 years. Recently restarted by Mr. Joe Zangaro, who has retired. The last 3 years, or 2.5 years, I should say, have been done virtually. So we're pretty excited to start this back in person. We have obviously a great group of kids here that, you know, it was said that this is the only award that you cannot earn by studying. You can't just get good grades and get this award. You have to be a good person. You have to show, as we said, our core values of, you know, empathy, perseverance, integrity, and gratitude. And somebody here, a staff member, has seen that in you guys as students. So we would like to take the time to, you know, show our gratitude and show our appreciation for what you guys do on a daily basis. So without further ado, I think unless Mr. Cheney has something to say.
I don't. Let's get started.
Let's get started.
Congratulations to everybody.
All right. Ken, thank you for coming. So to present our first 2022 People's Choice Award, Mrs. Michelle Malacrita.
Hi, guys. Okay, so I wanted to nominate for my People's Choice Award, Leah Jackson. Leah is such a great and cool kid. She has her own voice, opinions, and especially an amazing vibrance. She's worked successfully through many situations that have not been easy and has been humble and gracious through each and every single one of them. I give her so much credit for being a ninth grader and having so much confidence and so much maturity. So without further ado, Leah Jackson for People's Choice. And our next award is going to be presented by Miss Taglerino.
Sanaya is a hardworking, always pushing herself to achieve 100%. She is humble, gracious, and kind, both to her peers and to the staff. I appreciate the time she comes and spends during her lunch to continue working on piano and to talk. Sanaya, you have a bright future ahead of you, and I am looking forward to working with you for the next few years. Congratulations. Our next presenter will be Lieutenant Commander Lyons.
Strength, integrity, and respect are just a few of many words that I would use to describe my People's Choice recipient, Michaela Robinson Ellis. She has been a nice addition to our club this year. For Locke, Michaela is wise and mature and knows when to separate herself from people who are doing the wrong things. She is also very thoughtful and conscientious when it comes to completing tasks. She truly lets her light shine bright. Michaela? And the next award will be presented by Ms. Fabritz Rahana.
We're going to skip ahead for a moment. So my People's Choice Award is Leilani Brown. You could come up, Leilani. Leilani is a class leader who encourages others to succeed through positive reinforcement throughout our lessons. She, you're getting some love. She is the first to congratulate a peer on a job well done, encourages a student to stick with the task and come to a conclusion, and always provides positive reinforcement to those who participate. Leilani is a true friend to all students and an excellent role model. Come on up. The next award will be presented by Mrs. Hubble.
Good evening. So I didn't write anything because I feel like I'm better in the moment. And this young lady, is a sophomore, and it is her first year with us in our girls group here called LOCK. It stands for Ladies of Character and Knowledge. She exhibits everything we could hope for. She's free thinking, she speaks her mind, she knows her truth, and I believe she has something that's hard to come by these days, which is self-value. So my 2022 People's Choice Award is Evelyn Campos. I'm pleased to announce that the next presenter will be Mr. Machi.
Good evening, everyone. My nominee this year is a really, it's tough always to choose just one student. But this student really brightens my day every day. She comes into my class and, you know, she's always got a high five or, hey, Mr. Machi, how are you doing? What are we doing today? And she's just so enthusiastic and she's really great in class and she takes a leadership role and some of the proof in her class will be presented with their refreshments this evening. So I would like to present my award to Zaria Crossan, who's extremely deserving. One of my favorite kiddos this year. Our next presenter will be Mrs. Hubble.
Yes, me again. So I've also got the opportunity to meet another outstanding sophomore who has touched my heart in a way that I can't even put words to. She is unique and beautiful and smart, and there's just not enough adjectives because I'd be here all night. But I really aspire to learn things from this young lady. She does make everyone she comes in contact a better person if you take the time to actually speak to her. She's very soft-spoken. She's a wonderful young lady with a very bright future. My second 2022 People's Choice Award winner is Desiree Hartsfield. And the next presenters are a duo, Mr. Boschnack and Mrs. Sharp.
How are y'all doing tonight? Yeah? Give it up for these amazing People's Choice recipients. Give it up. They make the school a better place, each and every single one of them. It's very hard just to choose one. It's a very hard thing. All right, anyway, so I'm Mr. Boschnack.
And I'm Mrs. Sharp.
We are your student council advisors of the school. Yes.
And we selected a couple of fantastic students from our student council officers.
Yes, we have really, really good officers this year that make such a huge impact in our school. It's very hard just to recognize two. However, we had to. So the first one, Josh Horton, please come on up. Come on up, Joshua. This guy is one of the most spirited individuals in the entire school. Maybe in the years of what I've seen. Anyway, I'm going to keep it to the script here. Josh, you have an amazing outlook on life, and we very much appreciate your honesty. You are not afraid to stand up for what you believe in and back your words with action. You brighten up the room when you walk in and make the school a better place. You have been so helpful with many of our student council initiatives and someone we rely on to help make very important decisions for the school. We are excited to see what the world has in store for you after PTHS.
Our next recipient is Destiny Goodley. Destiny is our choice for People's Choice Award as a Student Council Social Media Director. You have gone above and beyond the call of duty. You have an immense impact on our school community with our innovative ideas and determination to see them through. As an officer for the past two school years, the way you have preserved through the pandemic, up until now has been remarkable to see. The work ethic you display is superior to your peers and even many adults in our working world. The sky's the limit with what you can accomplish in this world as you embark on college and as a career. Congratulations.
Yes, that's great. Yeah. Yeah. You do one, then I'll do that. Okay. We'll do it together. I'm in the back. I'm not going to photo. We really have to practice this next year.
Have a great evening, everyone.
And the next presenter is Miss Medina.
Buenas noches. Soy la señorita Medina. Buenas noches. Does anyone here speak Spanish? There are no words that are able to capture the essence of my People's Choice Award. They are love demonstrated over the 2 years I have known them, and the encouragement I have received from them on a daily basis is one of the richest rewards that teaching has afforded me. However, it has been challenges for me getting around because of my multiple sclerosis, but they make me want to get up every single day, look my absolute best, and teach the most amazing girls, Kalia and Jalen. I hope you feel the same way, and you will take what you have learned this year and build on it as you continue your studies. I love you both for a long time. Besitos y abrazos. And I just want to say there's another, you know, you want to pick so many students. Amaya, you know, I love you, and so many kids out there, but you can only pick one. I was able to pick two, but my first choice would be on, no, they're all special, but they're all specials. I'm not taking anything away from them, but there's one student, and I will explain later, but, and also Kalia Williams, I don't know if her mother's here, but she was my student. So, hola, wherever you are. You guys have great girls. Okay, you ready?
Good evening again. So I have the distinct pleasure of having two nominees. I co-advise the Future Educators of America Club with Mrs. Trosbach. And we have a member that has been pretty much there every day and never misses an appointment, never misses a meeting, always has great ideas, always willing to offer up, you know, advice to anybody. So let me read my little thing here. My People's Choice Award recipient is a member of the Future Educators of America Club. I chose this person based on the ease at which he makes people feel around him more comfortable. He expresses genuine interest in the well-being of his peers and his teachers. He is consistently helping others with schoolwork, giving advice for relationships, or, and this is kind of his thing, answering some of life's what-if questions. There is not a day that goes by that he is not living life, being the best version of himself. It's my honor to present my 2022 People's Choice Award to Nasir Langston. He's been bugging me for like 3 weeks. Did I write it? So now he knows. I tried to lie, but it didn't work. Thank you. Congratulations. The next presenter is going to be Mr. Fry and Mrs. Cornish.
So good evening, everybody. Thank you all for coming out and giving these kids their props. They deserve it.
They went through a lot the past couple of years. So the student that we are recommending for People's Choice Award for this year is Alexander Ribeiro.
We understand that Alice could not be here, but we wanted to show her the recognition for what she deserved. She really goes out of her way to let other students know how important they are. She'll help them in class without ever asking. They just give her a look, and she's willing to help. Something that she really brought that was really cool to my world, which is make it a safe zone for everybody else. She started a puzzle making club in the morning, and some students have been coming, and then they're getting to talk to everybody, and they're getting to know each other. So she's really at the forefront of a lot of little things that people don't realize how much of a difference she makes in the school. So we're sorry she couldn't be here, but we just wanted to tell everybody how appreciative we are of what she's done for at least me and Ms. Cornish. So
congratulations to all of you guys.
All right, my People's Choice recipient is Miss Amaya Richardson, who I do not believe is here tonight, but are you here? She's here? Woo! My girl is here! Yeah! All right, so let me read a little bit about her. Amaya is a kind and compassionate student who exemplifies empathy and has the perseverance to face obstacles head on. She has inspired me with her loyalty and care for other students in our school, and oftentimes advocates for them above herself. She doesn't put up with much, and she certainly doesn't mince words, but she inspires me to use my voice to stand up for those who may not stand up for themselves. So that is why I'd like to recognize Miss Amaya. And Miss Brewer will be next.
Good evening. I get the pleasure of giving my People's Choice Award to Charisma Robinson Ellis. Charisma displays academic excellence. She has set high goals for herself in high school and in pursuit of her career choices. She's gone above and beyond researching and pursuing enrichment opportunities available at colleges during summer months to help better prepare her for her future. She's a person of high integrity and shows gratitude for all the assistance she receives. She's pleasant and has a positive attitude. Every morning that I see her coming in when we're at the interest, never fails. She always greets us with a smile. And I am honored to have had the opportunity to counsel her at Harker-Wiley a few years back, and maybe some of the other ones that had the pleasure of going to Harker-Wiley. So it's been a pleasure. These qualities have made her my selection for the People's Choice Award this year. Congratulations. The next presenter will be Mrs. Herman.
Good evening. There aren't enough adjectives to describe this young man. Jenna Rojas was faced with a very tragic loss this year. After the loss of his mother, Jenna somehow managed to pull it together and be responsible, determined. He persevered through the most great personal pain and always showed responsibility with school and empathy toward his family, especially his sister. Jenner, you are one of the strongest individuals I've ever met. Jenna Rojas. While Jenner is my personal People's Choice recipient, it is only because I got to the form that needed to be filled out first. When Mrs. Medina explained her disappointment at coming in second, I knew I had to share my recipient with her.
So now you all know why I picked Jenner. I met Jenner. It was so tragic. He lost his mother. I'm such a crybaby. And they called me in to be there to tell him in Spanish. And I don't know how I kept it together. Mr. Dickinson was there. But I kept it together, and I told him that he lost his mother. Listen, my mother's 85. I can't imagine losing her now. But can you imagine such a tender age? So when I found out that she had her, I was like, oh, there's a problem. But I am so blessed. You know, when God winks, it's never a mistake. And he came into my life for a reason, and he's with me every day. And he says, I'm his second mom. I don't have children, so I said, I'm your mom now. And it's a good thing, but I love you, Jenner. And thank you. I will be there forever, okay?
Our next presenter is Mr. Volpe.
Good evening. Thank you for coming tonight. As everybody has mentioned, it's a great honor to get this back in person, and the people here this evening definitely enhance our school and make it much more enjoyable to come each day. The person I nominated is a person of high quality, shows amazing grit, perseverance, and all that he does. I'm so impressed with his well-roundedness as a student, getting involved in sports, volunteering his time, assisting in the 21st century after-school program. You always get a good feeling after having a good conversation with this young man. I believe his kindness, maturity, and positive attitude will bring him much success throughout his life. And you have to respect a man who works out with his father as a father of a son. Super enjoyable. So my person, People's Choice Award of 2022 is Reese Carpenter. And next up will be Ms. Adams.
Good evening, everyone. I nominate Ms. Kayla Carson, okay, as my People's Choice Award. Her integrity is exemplified through her consistency, her reliability, and responsibility in class and throughout class participation and assisting others. She demonstrates both perseverance and independence in class, and she completes her assignments on time, always excelling to her fullest. Her gratitude is acknowledged each time she asks for assistance or receives help when needed. I salute you, Ms. Kayla Carson. Yes. The next presenter I would like to bring up is Mr. Fowler.
Good Good evening. Thank you all for coming. Thank you for sending us such wonderful people. I'm going to read a little clue for my recipient. It's a quote from Mark Twain, very pertinent. Travel is fatal to bigotry and narrow-mindedness. My award winner is Ariana Colon. She's the greatest salesperson and fundraiser for one of her goals in life, to travel. And come on, well, you can come on up. She wants to travel, and I hope that for you, every journey becomes an adventure. And every adventure brings you peace, freedom, and joy. And she's a wonderful, wonderful person, a very valuable asset to the school. And make sure you see me in the fall for more fundraising things. But she knows what I like. I'm trying to take extra pictures. You're welcome. And thank you very much, Ariana. The next presenter will be Miss Mucci. Thank you. I don't know, two C's,
and I have two students today. So. My first student, unfortunately, is not here today, but I do feel like I need to express how I feel about her and why I chose her for People's Choice. Some of her family is here. Essence has been my student since she started at Pemberton Township High School. She's worked so hard, which has led her to become the person she is today. She went to the Senior Citizens Prom and was adored there. She's a hard worker and extremely caring. I couldn't ask for a more amazing student. She makes me proud every day. And I will give her her award when she returns. My next People's Choice Award student is Amari Copeland. I know she's really mad at me right now for doing this, but Amari has been my student since ninth grade. She's come a long way, and if anyone knows Amari, she's known best for advocating for herself. She's working hard to graduate early next year. She's grown so much since she started at Pemberton Township High School. She's always willing to help and will come to me if she needs assistance. I'm very proud of her.
Yes, because I was wondering for weeks.
Thank you, Amari. And the next presenters will be Mr. Boschneck and Ms. Sharp.
Okay, here we go. Okay, so congratulations to all the recipients. I'm proud to say that I've taught many of you. Honored to say I've taught many of you. Parents, you should be very proud. I have to say, I know everyone says that they had a lot of students to pick from, but when the email came out to pick the People's Choice Award, I had one student in mind. This student just makes my day every day. She walks in the room with a smile on her face, no matter how her day is doing, and she greets me and says hi. I had her in class twice, and it's just an honor to be able to honor her tonight. So my 2022 People's Choice Award recipient is Rachel Hussman. All right, so I'm just gonna read about Rachel when, as she's walking up. So I nominate Rachel for this award because she exemplifies the ideal Pemberton student. If every teacher had her, we will continue to teach. This is why we teach. We have students like Rachel. She just exemplifies our core values of the school. She's in the engineering program. She takes many AP courses. She worked very hard for me this year in AP Stat. She plays three sports and is in the engineering program. All right, and as I said, no matter how her day's going, she always greets me with a smile and makes my day. Rachel, thank you for making me want to teach, to continue to teach. Hold this. All right, and the next presenter is Mr. Salma.
All right, number two. So this student I've had for a couple years now. Unfortunately, the last two were in COVID, so I got to see him pretty much over the screen. This year, however, I do get to have him in one of my classes. He's a student in my consumer math class this semester. He's been a true model of consistency in and out of the classroom. He shows up every day eager to learn with a positive outlook. He shows gratitude for the opportunities placed in front of him daily, and he understands that it takes hard work to be successful. Recently, he received an invitation to apply for the National Honor Society here at PTHS. He came to me in the classroom and he said, "Mr. Zama, why did I get this?" I said, "I think it's because, you know, you're a great person. You earned the invitation. You're just a generally pleasant human being." So because of that, it is my distinct pleasure to give my 2022 People's Choice Award to Jack Fodarczyk. Present the next award, Mrs. Stellato.
Hi, friends. Can you hear me? Hi. That's some of my students. I'm Ms. Stellato. I teach English here at the high school. And this is actually my first year teaching. And I was so happy to share such a wonderful experience with one of my early graduate students named Elijah Alvarado. Talk about perseverance. The two of us persevered through first semester together. It was tough. Me going through growing pains here at the high school, and Elijah went through some of her own growing pains as well. I'm getting all teary-eyed. I thought it was just Miss Medina. But, you know, Alicia came to my class and on the first day said, "I don't know how to get to BCAF." And I said, "I'll take you there." And I walked her to BCAF. And the second day she said, "I never want to go to BCAF again. Can I have lunch with you every day?" And I said, "Absolutely, kiddo." And from there, not only did we build a great student-teacher relationship, but we also built a great friendship as well. Alicia has had to work very hard to meet many challenges coming back to school this year. She worked very hard in my English class. She prefaced how she felt about English. She said, "Miss S, I'm really slow at reading and I have a tough time writing. I don't know if I'm gonna do well in this class. Alasia passed my class with a 96 average. Alasia, yes, exactly. Please clap for her. Alasia was an exemplary student, and it was such an honor to watch her grow into the amazing young adult she is. I know that as she tries to navigate the world outside of PTHS, she is going to do great things. Unfortunately, she is not able to be here to receive her award tonight, but if we could, let's put our hands together one more time for Alasia Alvarado. Thank you. Let's see who's presenting next. It says Ms. Taglerino is our next presenter, but it might be someone else. We'll see.
I am presenting on behalf of Madame Tyler for Abigail Helm. Abby is a very kind and hardworking young woman. Although she has been confronted with very difficult challenges this past year in particular, she has persevered and demonstrated incredible resilience. She has empathy for others and seeks to help those around her to succeed. Abby will be greatly missed here at PTHS. I wish her incredible success and happiness in all of her future endeavors. Mrs. Ferguson will be our next presenter.
I'm honored to present Antonella Diaz Madrid as my People's Choice. As my People's Choice recipient for perseverance and gratitude. I first met Antonella this summer when she played the name game and memorized a room full of like 45 students. Do you remember that? 45 students. She memorized their personal interests, their names, and their characteristics. It was truly remarkable. Since then, I've seen Antonella every day. She's been checking on me, seeing if she could help me with something, or I find her and ask her to help me with something. It's really nice, and I'm truly grateful that I got to know her this year. She is a junior, but she persevered, and now she is a senior, and she's graduating and going to college. Yes. And Antonella is ambitious. She's considerate. She's outgoing, and I'm grateful, again, that I met you, and I look forward to hearing about all of your accomplishments. Our next presenter is Mr. Gurdon.
Hello. All right, so quick little story here. I have to tell you, before the very first days of school, you know, when teachers get their class rosters near that Labor Day start, I did scan through my classes, see who I had, who I knew, who I didn't, and it caught my attention that I had this one student in English 3 for first semester, and then again English 4 for second semester. Now, most of the time that happens, it's because the student in question needed to retake English 3, you know, after not doing it last year, and I admit that I was guilty of automatically assuming that was the case here. Well, boy, was I wrong. It did not take long for me to see that Malachi Johnson did not fall into that category. This young guy is amazing. You know, from the beginning, Malachi was doing great work in class. He was always involved in class discussions, you know, leading the way, and was volunteering to help out in any way he could. So whatever you need me to do, I'll do it, he said. And what you need to understand about Malachi Johnson is that he is hardworking. He's a determined young man who sets high standards for himself and continually meets those expectations. Malachi is set to graduate from PTAHS next month in only 3 full years. Yeah, that's only 6 semesters instead of the typical 8. All right. I don't know how he does it. He makes honor roll virtually every semester despite his busy schedule. He also works a few nights a week at a local restaurant. And Malachi was on a contestant in the recent Mr. Pemberton. And I know he was a big help as a student intern to Mr. Allenback during first semester. And you know, despite all of his accomplishments, all of his skills, probably the best part of Malachi is his personality. He comes in to class every day with a fist bump and a smile. And he has such a great outlook on life. And whatever the future may hold for him, I know it's definitely bright. Malachi, I need a fist bump. The next presenter is Hare Risley.
So let me find my German students out there. Mensch. Ah, okay. Hang on there. So, schönen guten Abend. Good. Oh, oops, okay. My People's Choice nominee is Joshua Kelleher. Yeah? So. Josh, a.k.a. Fritz, was a force of nature in my German program for 4 years. His enthusiasm and perseverance, whether in class or remotely online, were second to none. I can't recall one day in those years where he didn't come to class with a positive attitude, ready to give it all. His positivity is infectious, and I'll miss him next year. I'm not sure I miss his strange conspiracy theories, but I just kind of just smiled and said, yeah. But I know he is destined for great things, especially since he's going to my alma mater, TCNJ. Yeah? And so, Josh, fantastisch. Alles, alles Gute. So the next presenter is Mr. Allenback, in spirit with Mrs. Williams.
I am not Mrs. Williams, no. But Mrs. Williams calls me. And she said, can you present my People's Choice Award on the 17th because I can't make it? And I'm like, sure. That's what you do for friends. And then she said, it's Morgan Knight. And my first thought was, that's who I was going to pick. So after, you know, years of knowing Mrs. Williams, I just realized compromise is the best thing. We're going to co-present this. And I'm going to read what she wrote for you, Morgan. Morgan's tenacious and inquisitive attitude fosters her success in her academics, as well as her relationships with peers and staff. Each day, Morgan's curiosity, drive, and quick wit motivates others to grow and learn as she encourages all those in her path to challenge themselves and each other to be better individuals. Morgan is truly an inspiration to all who have the pleasure of her company, and she is a diamond of the first water in class. So that's from Mrs. Williams. Hallelujah.
As far as my part of this, I've been doing morning radio here at the school for about 17 years or so, and it's called The Morning Buzz, and it always goes well when it has a great crew and a really great team leader. And Morgan, come on up, share the stage with me. She appointed herself team leader early on, and she's done a great job. I know that she's going to be very successful in life just from watching her run a meeting. And I can't wait to see where life takes you. So may I present for Mrs. Williams and myself our 2022 People's Choice, Morgan Knight.
Okay, I'm back again. I'm Miss Rubin. So, for my next People's Choice Award recipient, I have utterly enjoyed watching this student sweat, trying to figure out who nominated him all week long. I have been working with Pedro. Crail Faria for the past 3 years, and most recently he has been my intern, which is amazing. He is very conscientious and takes pride in what he does, no matter how big or small the task. The same care and concern he has for his own family, he extends to his peers. He listens and he offers them good advice and solutions to any problems that they might have. He is definitely a gem, and he is our bright light in 209. Congratulations, Pedro. And the next presenter will be Mrs. Taglarino. Oh, I think it's Mr. Joseph.
All right, so I have two. So the first one is the one I actually chose. The second one I'll be reading for Miss Batala. So the student I chose is actually not here today, right? And I wasn't going to speak, but then I said, I want to speak anyway. And somebody back there said, no, I said, I'm the principal. And then I think that became it. But honestly, when we think about our seniors, right, the last year that seniors were in school for the full year was freshman year, right? If you could think that. Freshman year was the last year that they went from September to the end of the year, right? That sophomore year, around that March time, everything stopped. And they weren't back in. And then last year, junior year, some were here, some weren't. So it's hard. It's hard to pick a People's Choice Award winner. But my People's Choice Award winner is a student who demonstrated perseverance. I know she has a lot of struggles personally, medically, but she kind of persevered all the way from her freshman year to her senior year. I know she's at work right now, but I told her mom, who works in my office, Miss Longoria, that I was still going to shout her out. So my People's Choice Award winner is a student by the name of Jaden Longoria. So we're going to act like she was here and do all the clapping. You could do the fake pic. No? No fake pic, no? All right, and then the second student, again, is for Miss Batala. As you know, we're close to graduation, right? And probably the hardest thing when we get to graduation is pronouncing names right all the time. So this is gonna be practice for me today as we get to this point. So Ms. Batala selected a student by the name of Jelena Lumumba. Jelena, did I get it right, Jelena? Is Jelena here? Come on up. I know Jelena well. So Jelena transferred to PTHS at the start of 10th grade As a reserved, quiet lady, always polite, with a slight smile for anyone who greeted her, over the past 3 years, she has gained friends and trusting connections to most of her teachers. Jelena worked hard academically and looks forward to her high school graduation. She has plans on full-time employment this summer and then vocational school for the following fall. So again, congratulations to Jelena for being People's Choice Award winner. At this time, I think I'm calling Ms. Rayner to the stage.
Good evening, everyone. Okay. So the person receiving the award that I suggested tonight is not here, so I will miss him dearly, but this is a shout out to him when he does see this later. My nominee of 2022 People's Choice Award is Jack McCallum. He is a prime example of a student who works past all of his obstacles to get to his goals. No matter what it takes, he is a true definition of perseverance. Whether it's academics, student leadership, or finding the best vintage piece in the thrift store, he will shop, he will study, he will participate, he will do all new things to get to his goal. Combine new pieces with the old and the new. His determination is clear as he just graduated from RCBC last week with his associate's degree, and he's graduating an entire year early from PTHS as well. I cannot wait to see where his passions take him as he starts at American University in Washington, D.C. this fall. And thank you so much. I hope you all have a great night, and congratulations to all of our students. The next presenter will be Mrs. Henshaw.
Hello, I'm presenting this award on behalf of Ms. Mizrak. She's my co-avid teacher. And this award is for Lily. Lily is a dedicated and respectful young lady. In the 4 years I've known her, she has never given up when things got tough. Lily has always persevered until she got what she was driving towards. Lily's also grateful for every opportunity she has been given. I know she will go far after high school, and I'm excited to see all that she achieves. Got another one. Okay. This award is also on behalf of Ms. Mizrak. She is nominating or is giving this award to Kaiesia Rittenberg. Kaiesia has grown so much over the last 4 years. She has developed high morals and standards. She has learned to advocate for herself, for what she wants and believes. She is the true definition of an avid student. Kaiesia will go far and achieve many goals. Okay, I have one more. This award, I nominated this person. I have taught this person for the last 5 or 6 years, and the first day that she walked into my seventh grade room, I've been wrapped around her finger ever since, because what Alexis wants, Alexis gets. So my nomination for People's Choice Award is Alexis Ray, Miss Thang. Alexis Ray. In the time that I have taught Alexis, she has battled an illness that has put her in and out of the hospital and placed her on homebound instruction for 3 separate occasions, months at a time. Alexis never used her illness as an excuse to not succeed in classes. She is the poster child of a person that has persevered through her obstacles and managed to finish in the top 15% of her class. Alexis has been accepted into Monmouth University's nursing program. She continues to push herself to achieve her dream, becoming a nurse. My job. Next presenter is Mr. Dickinson.
Good evening, everyone. First of all, I want to thank the parents and guardians, because honestly, these young men, young women wouldn't be here without your dedication to a successful parenting. So my People's Choice Award recipient, I said, who has my physical characteristics? That's like 6'2", has long flowing hair, and is thin. I said, you know, he's got to look like me. So, let me introduce you to Gavin Stuhler. Come on up, Gavin. See the similarities now? I first met Gavin as a freshman, and I'm fortunate to have observed him over the 4 years mature into this young man that he is. During these past 4 years, we talked about wrestling, soccer, and family. And I nominated him for gratitude because he certainly expressed gratitude for his coaches, his teammates, and his family. As an educator, it's really critical to have bonds with your students and be able to speak to them honestly and give honest feedback. This year, I've seen Gavin almost every single morning. And it really, as a senior and as a male, the stereotype doesn't fit him because he really is a genuine good person. And each morning when I would see him, it was always a smile, and it still is a smile. And he would always say, hey, Mr. Dickinson, how are you doing today? Good morning, Mr. Dickinson, how are you? So again, I'm really grateful for Gavin, because he truly makes my day every day. I'd like to introduce Mrs. O'Connick at this time. Hey, Gavin. I can't take this home, man. Come on.
Good evening, everyone. I'd just like to say thank you for coming out tonight and for recognizing all of our students. I like to select seniors because I feel like I've worked with them for a very long time, and I'm blessed to be able to introduce my People's Choice Award for 2022, Miss Kyla Thomas. I have had the pleasure of knowing Kyla since she was in seventh grade. I actually was very excited to leave Helen Fort Middle School about 4 years ago and come here to work at the high school. And I've had the pleasure of working with Kyla for all these years. Kyla is dynamic, energized, and one of the most thoughtful young women I've known in all my years working in Pemberton Township. She earns top grades in her classes. Kyla works hard, she participates in extracurricular activities, and she works outside of school too. Kyla embodies the character traits we all seek in our students, and she is my People's Choice Award nominee 2022. As she prepares to graduate, head off to college, go Kyla, I am so proud of you. Congratulations. Mr. Zalma will be reading the last award for a wonderful senior named Jessica.
All right, guys. Thank you for staying through, sticking it out with us. So the next award was actually nominated by Mrs. Downs, the school nurse. She can't be here tonight. So I would like to obviously give out this award to the student. Mrs. Downs liked to say that she's nominating Jessica Fedorchek for the People's Choice Awards. She's known Jessica for many years, but to watch her grow into the young woman she is today has been very rewarding. She's honest, she's hardworking. Even though at times she's gonna refuse to accept the award or the compliment, she knows that she's grateful. She tries hard, even if she fails, she will continue to move forward and take the steps to succeed. Is, you know, with our pleasure to give the last 2022 People's Choice Award, only because of her last name, to Jessica Fedorchek. She's not here. Unfortunately, she's not here tonight. So, again, thank you for coming out. Mrs. Shaney's got some things real quick.
All right, well, first of all, let's say a big congratulations to our 2022 People's Choice Award winner. Stand up.
Come on. Congratulations, everyone.
So as Mr. Salma said in the beginning, this award is for being a good person. When it comes down to it, you're doing the right thing, you're helping others, and you're being all around wonderful people. And we appreciate that so much here at PTHS and in our community. So we would like to thank all of you for doing what you do. We wish you luck in all of your future adventures. And thank you to the parents and guardians for raising such wonderful children that we get the privilege of teaching every day. Please enjoy some light refreshments out front, and now we can take some pictures and have a great time. Nice job, guys.
Drive home safe.